Now we come across different questions regarding this topic of collisions. So in collisions, there are two things that you have to know. One is objects collide in two different ways. One is elastic. The other one is inelastic. Now, first let's define what is elastic collisions. When you hear the term elastic, it means there is no loss of energy. When two objects collide, they collide in such a way that there is no loss of energy. We know that in real life, when two objects collide, there is a generation of sound, generation of heat, loss of materials, and many other things. But in a perfectly ideal situation, that is in elastic collision, there is no loss of energy. That is, the momentum of the system, the momentum of the system gets conserved. This is getting conserved. So this is what you have to know about elastic collision. And if there is a loss of energy and the momentum is not conserved, then that type of collision is known as inelastic collision. That type of collision is known as inelastic collision. So this is all you have to know about elastic and inelastic collisions. So the question that often come will be in regard to elastic collision. That is, the situation will be ideal. In ideal situation. So in ideal situation, the total momentum of the system gets conserved. Say suppose this is your mass m1, this is m2. So if you're considering the momentum of the object m1, so the momentum will be given by p1 is equal to, that is the change in momentum. There is a change in momentum. So the change in momentum is given as F1, force that is applied because of the interaction of object 1 and 2. Because of the interaction of object 1 and 2. That is the force F12. I have written force F12. What does force F12 imply? Force F12 is actually equal to force exerted on 1, on this particular. If I name this on 1 and if I name this on force exerted on 1 by 2. This collides with this. If this is colliding, we can say or we can understand this in such a way that this object, the force that is given by this object on this, that is F1 of 2, force exerted on, this is 1 is on 1 by 2. This is what F12 actually means. So force exerted on 1 upon 2 and del t for a small amount of time, del t. Now why is this change in momentum is equal to force into del t? This came because we know force is equal to rate of change of momentum with respect to time. This was our definition of momentum change or force. This came from your second law. This came from your second law of Newton. So please see laws of motion. Second law of Newton or motion. So please consult our previous videos if you have any confusion. Now what about momentum of object 2 is equal to force on 2 because of 1, and that is del t. This is del t. But we know F of 1, 2 is actually equal to f of 2, 1. Now, why does it come? Why does it come like this? Because, say suppose, if we are applying a force of f to this wall, by Newton's third law, please refer to this chapter. By Newton's third law, if I apply a force of F over here, then the wall also applies a force opposite to this force, but similar in magnitude. This is F. If a force of F is applied over here, the wall also applies a force of F. So if this is F12 is equal to F of minus 21. This is a force which is opposite in nature. So if this is my equation 1 and if this is my equation 2 and if I add 1 plus 2, this is minus of F12. F21 can also be written as minus of F12. So this equation actually implies del P1 plus del P2 is equal to 0. Now, mathematically, we have found that del P1 and del P2 is equal to 0. So, what does this mean? This means that the forces may vary, but the conservation, that is the total impulse on the first object, is equal to that on the second object. That is total force or the total impulse. Now, force for a very short interval of time is also known as impulse. I've used the term impulse, so I'm explaining you what is impulse. So in this way, it does not matter whether you increase the momentum of P1 or whether you increase the momentum of P2. The overall total momentum is always a constant, that this is zero. That is, the system's momentum is conserved. So this is very important. And if questions do come, please write this particular answer in your examination.